Hi, we're Mallory and Savannah from the DIY blog Classy Clutter. Today we're going to be talking about patio pavers and how we went from this to this and made a lot more functional for our family. Our back patio had outdoor carpet that needed to be replaced, and now is a beautiful space that we can entertain all kinds of guests. Now let me show you how to install patio pavers. First, you're going to clear the area and remove any debris that may be in the way. We also had a few low spots, and so we had to bring in some extra fill dirt to make it a little bit more level. Now it is time for the paver base. The paver base is used to create a stable foundation for the pavers. We did about a 1-inch layer of this base, and we raked and leveled it out away from the house. We used a 2x4 to help screed and level out the base and make sure that everything was nice and smooth. After everything was level, we sprayed it down with a little bit of water, and using a vibrating plate compactor, we compacted the base so it would be solid and a firm foundation. We repeated this step a few times until our foundation was completely solid and level. Now it is time to lay the pavers. We used a Pavestone pavers from Home Depot, and we love how it turned out. These are 12-inch by 8-inch pavers, which make it so nice when we had 1,200 square feet to cover. We decided to do a herringbone pattern that we saw on Pavestone's website. We started by laying the whole pavers first. This part went fairly quickly. During install in this large area, we had to pay close attention to our high and low spots, and we screeded the paver base as needed. After all the whole pavers were laid, it is now time to measure, mark, and make cuts to complete laying the pavers. We used a rafter square, a marker, tape measure, and a 4-pound dead blow hammer. First, you measure the space. Then you measure and mark your paver. To cut the pavers, we rented this paver saw from Home Depot's rental center. After the cuts are made, use a dead blow hammer and tap the paver into place. After you have all of the pavers laid, now it is time to broom or sweep the paver sand into the joints to lock the pavers into place. This is going to be your final step. Now you can enjoy your beautiful new space. I loved how everything turned out. We completed the space by adding some new furniture, and now we are ready to entertain our friends and family in our new space. We love our space, and I'm excited for the memories that we will create here. Be sure to like and comment below. For more DIY projects and tutorials, check out classyclutter.net.